Welcome to another session on design of helical gear. Today we will see the center center distance question. So this is our question. Design a pair of helical gears to transmit 20 kilowatts at 1440 rpm of the pinion. Teeth are of 14.5 degree involute. Center center distance between the gears is 400 mm. So we have center center distance. So center center distance, if the diameter is d1 and d2, center center distance will be d1 plus d2 by 2, and that value is given as 400 mm. D1 plus d2 by 2 equal to 400 mm. For the transmission ratio is 4:1, so d2 by d1 equal to 4, which gives d1 equal to 160 mm and d2 equal to 640 mm. Now we go to the first step. We have to select the material. It is given that we have to select a material for which it is not given where the which material to be selected. So we have to select a material from this table, table 12.7 in page 234. In this case, we will select cast steel 0.2% heat treated 193.2, that is sigma d, and BHN value equal to 250. We select those values. So sigma d equal to 193.2 for both pinion and gear, and BHN value equal to 250. After selecting the material, we have to select the weaker element. If both are made of same material, we need not do the strength factor. We can directly write, of course, y equal to 0.154 minus 0.684 by z for 14.5 degree in value. This is our equation. Since z1 is less than z2, y1 will be less than y2. In such case, sigma d1 y1 will be less than sigma d2 y2. Provided they are of same material, when sigma d1 equal to sigma d2, y1 will be less than y2. We can say that strength factor will be lower for the pinion. So, pinion will be the weaker element. We can design the pinion. So, pinion will be the weaker element. This completes our second step. Now, what is the third step? We have to find the module. And for helical gears, as we have already discussed in the previous lectures, we can see that we have to find the normal module. To find the normal module, we have this equation from page 214, equation 12.24b, mn square equal to mn cube equal to 2mtcw cos beta. Okay, we'll see one by each term by term. First, we'll find what is the torque applied. We'll find the torque applied for which power is given. Power equal to 20 kilowatts. So, mt equal to, we can directly write mt equal to 60 p by 2 pi n. Power equal to 20 kilowatts, 20 into 10 power 6 newton millimeter per second. N equal to 1440 rpm for the pinion. We will get mt equal to 132.6 into 10 power 3 newton millimeter. So we have found the value of mt, that is the torque. Now, you would have remembered in the previous slide, Cw is the wear and lubrication factor. We can find it from a table. So, Cw is the wear and lubrication factor from page 241, table 12.21. We can find that value. Just in the similar slides, we will take one among these. We will take, assume enclosed gears, then it's lubricated, take Cw equal to 1.15. So, assume enclosed gears and write all those. Take Cw equal to 1.15. Sigma d is known, 193.2, and cos beta equal to cos 18 degree. Now we will see the other terms in the equation. We have to find phase width. Phase width equal to 1.1 pi mn by sin beta and k equal to b by mn. So k will be equal to 1.1 pi by sin beta, and that value will be equal to 11.18, taking beta equal to 80 degree, which is given in the question. After finding k, the remaining terms are capital Y and Z. Capital Y equal to pi Y. So we don't know the value of Y as such. So we will write Y equal to pi Y as such. Then Z equal to, we should write Z in terms of the normal module. So Z equal to D cos beta by MN. We have from page 211, equation 12.19D, Z equal to D cos beta by MN. Since we are designing the pinion, I can write D1 cos beta by MN. What was the value of D1? That is 160 mm. So 160 cos beta equal to 18 degrees divided by MN. So that value will come around to 152.16 by MN. We will substitute all those values in this equation. So we have got the value Z equal to 152.16 by MN. After substituting all the terms, so we have empty Cw. So we substitute empty equal to 132.63 into 10 power 3. That's a torque in Newton millimeter. We should be always careful about the units. Cw equal to 1.15, assuming enclosed gears. Cos beta equal to cos 18 degree. Sigma d equal to 193.2 Newton per mm square. We can find the value of Cv from the velocity. We will do that. K equal to 11.18. Capital Y, I'll write as pi Y. We don't know the value of Y. Z equal to 152.16 by MN. Now, we can find the velocity. What is the velocity given? We can find the velocity. Velocity equal to pi d n by 60. Velocity equal to pi d1 n1 by 60 equal to pi into diameter. We have to substitute in meters because we should get the velocity in meters per second. So pi into 160 mm equal 0.16 meter multiplied by 1440 all divided by 60. You will get that value equal to 12.06 meters per second. Then we can find the Cv. So in this case, our velocity is in between 10 to 20 meter per second. So Cv will be equal to 15.25 divided by 15.25 plus V equal to 12.06. So we can find that value equal to 0.5584. So we have got all the terms in that equation for MN. So C, I will add Cv also in this equation. So Cv equal to 0.5584. Here there is an MN. MN will get cancelled out. One of the MN will get cancelled out. We will get MN square Y. MN square Y equal to, after substitution, you will get MN square Y equal to 0.5032. Now we will find the MN from tabular column method. Most interesting part of this question. We will find MN. We will do by the trial and error method. So our required MN square value should be just above 0.5032. So we can find that value. So I'll write that value, required value 0.5032. First we'll start with an initial value of 2 mm. We have to substitute as mm itself. Then Z equal to, we can write Z in terms of diameter, Z equal to d cos beta by ml from this equation. So Z equal to d cos beta, that is d equal to 160 cos beta, cos 18 divided by mn equal to, after substitution you will get 152.18 by mn. Now we substitute that 2 mm, so we will get 152.18 divided by mn, you will get 1 equal to 152.18 divided by 2, you get 76.08. We can either take 76 or 77. Here I am taking 76. So Lewis form factor, that equation for 14.5 degree involute, you can refer the data book, y equal to 0.124 minus 0.684 by ZE1, where ZE1 equal to Z1 by cos cube beta. Substituting this value of Z, you will get y equal to 0.1163. And mn square y will be equal to 2 square into 0.1163. That value will be equal to 0.4652. But our required value is 0.5, so it is lower. So 2 mm is not safe. Now we will go to the next trial. We will check with 3 mm. We will get Z1 equal to 152.18 by 3. You will get around 50.7. I can take it as higher value 51, or 50 is also can be taken. Taking 51, I can find Z1, and after substitution you will get y equal to 0.1125. And mn square y will be equal to 1.0467. So this value is greater than the required value, that is 0.503. So we can select this value as a standard module for the design of the gears. And we can check whether our Z1 is greater than the minimum number of this. Here we have got for module equal to 3 mm, we have got Z1 equal to 51. And for 14.5 degree involute, minimum number of teeth should be 32. So this 51 is safe with respect to minimum number of teeth also. So it can withstand the load and it has the minimum number of teeth also. That completes our third step. So standard value of mn equal to 3 mm. From that we can find the value of mt, that is the transverse module. Transverse module can be found, and depending upon MT, we can find all the dimensions of the gears from page 230. Now we have to find the dynamic load from page 214, equation 12.2. When you see such big equations, smile at them, because if you get tensed, you will make all those mistakes. You take one each term by term. First we will find ft equal to 2mt by d1. We know all those values, just we have to make sure that our mind is cool. We have to substitute it, wait, right, 132.6 into 10^3 whole divided by our new value of diameter will be equal to 160.87. you will get ft equal to 1648.91. So ft equal to 1648. Then we have other values, k3 equal to 20.67, k3 equal to 20.67, We have already found the velocity. Velocity equal to 12.13 meters per second. Then B is known. B equal to 11.18 mn. We can find that value equal to 33.5 mm. Then cos beta equal to cos beta equal to cos 18 degrees. Then we have to find the value of C. C is the dynamic factor. For finding the value of C, well, initially we had to find the value of F. We have to find the value of F, error in action. Our velocity is 12.13. So, plotting for 12.13 from figure 12.5. So, take that value 12.13 meter per second. Our value of F will be equal to somewhere around just below 0.04, 0.038. Now, after getting the value of F, that is 0.038, we can take that value into that table for finding the dynamic factor. This is our table. So, in this case, it is 14.5 degrees. So, we take the first set of values. Both are made of steel. So, I will take the third row. Our value is 0.038, which lies in between 0.04 and 0.06. So, for 0.04, my value is 441.3, and for 0.06 it is 662.0. My value is it's in between 0.03 and 0.04. So my value is 0.04, both steel and steel, 4.03, my value will be equal to 313.9, it will be 441.3. So, I can find the value of C. How will you find the value of C? You put the numbers 1, 2 and 3. 3 minus 1 by 2 minus 1. For doing the same step in both rows, I can write third one minus first one divided by second one minus first one. Do the same operation in row 1 and row 2. Row 1 and row 2. I can write 0.04 minus 0.03 divided by 0.038 minus 0.03 equal to 441.3, third one minus first one 330.9 divided by 2 minus 1, C minus 330.9, I will get C equal to 419.2, that much newton per millimeter. So I got all the values, and after substitution I will get, so we will write all those values. So Ft equal to 1648.91, K3 equal to 20.67, velocity equal to 12.13 meters per second, then B equal to, what was the value, B 33.5 mm, then C equal to this value 419.2, and cos beta equal cos 25, cos 18, and after substitution we will get FD equal to 10,000. FD, you can find those value. And after substitution, you will get FD equal to 10,885.1 newton. Now we have to find FW, whether it will produce wear and tear or not. FW equal to D1BQK, we know those values. D1 equal to 160.87 mm, B equal to 33.4 mm, and Q equal to 2Z2 by Z1 plus Z2 1.6, and cos beta equal cos square, cos beta equal cos 18, cos square 18 degree. We can find that value equal to FW equal to 9532.97 K, equating FD equal to FW, equating FD equal to FW. You will get K equal to 1.142. I will see the table. From table 12.16 for 14.5D, that is the second last row, I have to get a value which is greater than 1.14. So my value 1.174, it is greater than 1. So I can select this value 1.177. For that, my BHN value will be 350 and 300. So initial hardness was 250 BHN, it should be heat treated to 350 BHN for the pinion, and for gear it should be heat treated to 300. Then I can use this value of k equal to 1.177. I can take this value and find the new value of FW equal to 9532.97 K, substituting this value 9532 into 1.177, my new value will be equal to 11,290 newton. So I can write the inference, and so in this case FW, new value of FW will be equal to 11,219. That's a minimum load, load required for wear is greater than the applied load, applied dynamic load, that is 10,885 newton, and thus the dimensions are safe. And after doing all these steps, you write all the dimensions in page 230 in terms of MT. You can find the value of transverse module. Okay, thank you for viewing. Thank you.